My name is Mike Butler. I'm an architectural photographer. I've been a photographer my whole life. I first picked up a camera when I lived in Bangkok, Thailand with my family. It was my father's old Nikon F-3 with a single 50mm lens. It was a manual camera with hand-rolled film. It was the simplest kind of photography, the street photography, the decisive moment. Go out with the camera, one lens, 36 black and white shots, and see what you can pick up. Go back to the lab, develop it, go back out, do it again. It was a slow process, but I think it gave you time to really think about what you were doing. Later on in my career, as I came back to the US, I went to art school for a couple years and ended up, luckily enough, being accepted into an apprenticeship with a master photographer, Dan Forer, who showed me this entire new universe of lights and techniques of architectural photography, which I really gravitated towards. It was a very meticulous workflow that took a long time. The focus of the camera, the Polaroids, the setting of the lights, everything had to be hidden. And you could spend hours doing something like this. And when you shot the film, that was it. If you process the film, as long as you got the exposure correct, you're good to go. You deliver the film. And that, when I launched out on my own career, I took that with me and built upon that in a way. And initially, I did shoot 4x5. I did shoot 4x5 chrome, but quickly switched over to NPS, which is a negative film, a 4x5 negative film, which had a little bit more latitude, a little bit less expensive, and allowed me to start basically layering up shots, adding lights into the shot, shooting it, taking the light out, shoot it again. And then sometimes I would take that digital image, output it to a piece of 4x5 chrome and deliver that to the client. And they had no idea that all this digital manipulation was going on. As digital came online, I continued to increase the complexity of the productions. And I think it really came to an apogee in 2010 when I photographed the Bihilio Barco Library in Bogota, Colombia. It's essentially an unlightable building, right? It's not a building you would necessarily light because it's a purely architectural structure. But me, being who I am, I just said, well, screw it, let's just do it. Let's just make this thing happen. Let's see what goes on. You know, we created these beautiful images, of course, and a totally different style than this architecture would normally be shot in really a natural light space. From there, since 2010 till now, photography has changed a lot. I mean, the aesthetics, what people want changed. So they've less production, less light, more open, right? But what remained constant through all that is light. And light is quite magical when you think about it, because if you look at it from a physics point of view, light is both a particle and a wave. It's two things at the same time. And if you look at it, it changes. If you observe it, right, with a scientific instrument, it changes its form. And that's crazy. That's kind of magical, right? And it's the fastest thing in the universe. It's 186,000 miles per second. And what's spooky is if you try to get close to the speed of, if you try to get a ship and you try to accelerate it towards the speed of light, as you get closer and closer, the ship becomes heavier and heavier. And you can never get to the speed of light. Now, that's crazy. But what the most magical thing about light is the simplicity of it. Go to your room, turn on the light, what happens? It magically appears. Turn off the light, it disappears instantly. And what you're left with when you turn off the light is the absence of light, which is as powerful, if not more powerful, than the light itself. And I think in imagery, that darkness is so important, to have a little darkness, right? Because that's life. And our images, if we're true artists, should contain some darkness. It's just the way life is. And if you look at a lot of my work, you'll see those dark shadows looming or within the background, but they're there, right? And I incorporate them to add sensitivity to the aesthetics of the shot, right? And I know now everybody likes to shoot open and airy and lovely, and that's actually quite nice and it's lovely. But shadows do represent like one of the duality, right? The other half of light. And you can't have just one half of something if it contains another half. And being that light is so magical and so ephemeral that it's here and gone, like you can't catch it, you can't catch up to it. As photographers, right? Any photographer capturing light, you are essentially capturing and putting in prison this light for somebody else to see. And what's so cool about that is that if you're truly an artist and you think about your work, even in the smallest way, you're imprinting your thoughts into that piece of acetate or digital medium, right? And somebody else can perceive those feelings or thoughts. And that's kind of this transactional thing that happens with photography. And I'm a commercial shooter, but I still try to incorporate that art, that feeling into images when I can. And this is in itself magical. And it makes us as photographers, these bounty hunters, going to capture these mystical creatures, you know, the duality of light and darkness. And, you know, looking back on my career, there was a moment when I thought, wow, I was going to be a fighter pilot, right? And I was going to be less, and I just didn't have the math to do that. But really, you know, I never had an option. I think I was destined to be a photographer. I was born to do this. I could be nothing else.